New drivers, new cars, and a new Formula One season. But it's the same Albert Park that we've come to know and love for more than two decades now that hosts the first round of a 21 race championship, taking us from here in Melbourne, Australia, across the globe, before we eventually reach the season finale at Yas Marina Circuit in Abu Dhabi. Just south of Melbourne's downtown business centre is the one and only Albert Park Circuit. 3.3 miles of public roads, closed for the weekend of course, make for a bumpy circuit with little undulation. There are 16 corners around the lake and a couple of good passing opportunities here as well, thanks in part to the DRS zones into turns 1, 3 and 13. I'm joined today in the commentary box, as I will be throughout this season, by a great racing driver, former F1 competitor, man who was world champion once upon a time as well, and an all-round top chap. It's the one and only Anthony Davidson. And tell me, here we are, first Grand Prix of the season, the first time racing these cars. So what are the big questions that need to be answered here, in your view?
First of all, Crofty, and thanks for the glowing introduction. I just want to say it's a real privilege to be here, and I can't wait to see what this competitive field has in store for us this season. Now, to answer your question, obviously there's the question of performance in race trim, but really this is going to be all about reliability. It's the first Grand Prix of the season, don't forget. You're pushing all your new components to their limits. Formula One cars are full of very sophisticated but also very sensitive technology. So the most important thing today is to get to the end of the race, keep everything in good condition, and try to stay out of trouble while you're at it.
We're almost ready to go then, and this is what the starting grid looks like for today's race. Davidson lines up on pole position, and it's Charles Leclerc in P2. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Alonso, Ocon, Sergio Perez, and Verstappen, Hamilton, Vettel, Sainz, and Pierre Gasly, Hülkenberg, Stroll, Marcus Ericsson, and Sorokin, Grosjean, Ricciardo, Kimi Raikkonen, and Brendan Hartley. Bottas and Kevin Magnussen rounds off the grid. And now, it's time to head down to the track.
Pole position. Let's go for the win. Okay, our system checks are good. We need to stay in formation and start bringing the car up to temperature, please. Get some load into the tyres and work the brakes. We want them nice and warm by the end of the lap. No rain expected. No rain expected for the time being. The rest of the grid is forming up. Be patient and watch for the lights. We're looking good from the start. We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the super softs. Great work. That's a new fastest lap for the race. We're leading our teammate by 14.5 seconds. We're going to box this lap. Push hard on the in-lap. Pit now. Go. Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. We're 3 laps over target on fuel. Let's start burning it off, please. Fernando's in for his stop. The gap behind us is 10.6 seconds. Good job. That was the fastest lap of the race so far. gap to teammate behind is 44.5 seconds. Some information on Alonso. They're slowing down. It seems like there's some kind of problem with their car. Okay, the safety car is out. The safety car is out. We need to form up at a reduced pace. Keep a close eye on that delta time. Make sure to keep it positive. Some information on Gasly. They are out of the race. Okay, slow down. Your delta is negative, which means you are too fast. Reduce your pace. We're coming up to the safety car now. Do not pass it. You are the leader. Follow the safety car. The safety car is waiting for the leader. You may overtake it. Overtake the safety car. We have 5 laps of fuel remaining. OK, the safety car is coming in this lap. We'll be pacing the field in sector 3. Make sure to respect the delta until the safety car is in the pit lane. This is your final lap of the race. Okay, you're creating some breathing space between you and the car behind by a few seconds per lap. There's 3 laps of fuel remaining. Absolutely fantastic. It's a brilliant result. Well done.
McLaren have pulled it off. They've won in spectacular fashion here today. So, Ant, how exactly did they set themselves apart from the pack today?
Well, they played the safety car to absolute perfection. There are so many factors to worry about once the race is neutralised. I mean, do you pit for fresh rubber? Do you have the space behind you? How much fuel can you save? If you answer all of those questions correctly, you'll have a good chance. And that's exactly what happened today.
Our drivers are making their way out for the podium celebrations, and it's going to be McLaren picking up the winner's trophy. Congratulations to the entire team for that fantastic performance. Thank you. And now let's take a look at the driver's standings. Davidson takes over the lead of the Drivers' Championship. Now then, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
I think I'm going to give it to Daniel Ricciardo. He's come through the field so well today, you know. Well deserved.
And now let's take a look at the constructors' standings. McLaren move to the top of the table. After all that excitement, it's time for a lie down, I think. Thanks for joining us, and goodbye until the next race.